You are not quite as callow as I thought. That is unexpected. You're welcome. I caged myself. A weak mind is a deadly foe, as you are no doubt aware. That is complicated. I told you before that I was sent here. I was not sent alone. I came to your lands with seven of the Beresad, my brothers, to seek answers about the Blight. We made our way across the Ferelden countryside without incident, seeing nothing of the threat we were sent to observe. Until the night we camped by Lake Kalanhad. They came from everywhere. The earth beneath our feet, the air above us. Our own shadows harbored the darkspawn. I saw the last of the creatures cut down, too late. I fell. I am told no others survived. I don't know how long I lay on the battlefield among the dead, nor do I know how the farmers found me. I only know that when I woke, I was no longer among my brothers, and my sword was gone from my hand. Perhaps. I searched for it, and when that failed, I asked my rescuers what had become of it. I killed them with my bare hands. I did. I knew they didn't have the blade. They had no reason to lie to me. I panicked. Unthinking, I struck them down. That sword was made for my hand alone. I have carried it from the day I was set into the Beresad. I was to die wielding it for my people. Even if I could cross Ferelden and Teventer unarmed and alone to bring my report to the Arishok, I would be slain on sight by the Antam. They would know me as Solas, a deserter. No soldier would cast aside his blade while he drew breath. We know who we are, and what we are meant to be. Near Lake Kalanhad. Perhaps those words are empty, but thank you all the same.
Here I am. Oh, this should be good. Go ahead. And why not? There are many things to enjoy about being a crow in Antiva. You're respected, you're feared. The authorities go out of their way to overlook your trespasses. Even the rewards are nothing to turn your nose up at. As for the killing part, well, some people simply need assassinating. Or do you disagree? I often find myself the instrument of fate, ending these lives for one necessity or another. I console myself with the notion that most of them had it coming. As far as enjoying the act of killing itself, why not? There is a certain artistry to the deed, the pleasure of sinking your blade into their flesh and knowing that their life is in your hands. There are many things I did not enjoy about being a crow, of course. Having no choice, being treated as an expendable commodity, the rules, oh, so many rules. But simply being an assassin, I like it just fine. I will continue to do it if I can, even if I am not a crow. Honestly, could you picture me doing something else? None that I wouldn't get into trouble for performing publicly. Of course, all these thoughts are moot. Chances are still good that you and I will perish, eaten by darkspawn or slain by the crows at some point. Very gruesomely, I imagine. But it is pleasant enough to chat about. Come, let's move on while our boots still have some wear in them.
I shall do it. What do you wish of me? We are in camp, so 'tis as good a time as any. What do you wish of me? If you must. Why do you ask me such questions? I do not probe you for pointless information, do I? Any number of cats could inform you of the answer to that question, but have it your way. What is it you asked if I grew up in the wilds? A curious question. Where else would you picture me? For many years it was simply Flemeth and I. The wilds and its creatures were more real to me than Flemeth's tales of the world of man. In time, I grew curious. I left the wilds to explore what lay beyond, never for long. Brief forays into a civilized wilderness. Would you not do the same? Your world is an unforgiving and cold place. The wilds I hail from is home to me, and I a natural denizen. For all that I had been taught, however, the truth of the civilized lands proved to be overwhelming. I was unfamiliar with so much. So confident and bold was I, yet there was much that Flemeth could never have prepared me for. Was I hurt? What manner of simpering weakling do you take me for? Only once was I accused of being a witch of the wilds, and that by a chastened who happened to be traveling with a merchant caravan. He pointed and gasped and began shouting in his strange language, and most assumed he was casting some curse upon me. I acted the terrified girl, and naturally, he was arrested. Men are always willing to believe two things about a woman. One, that she is weak, and two, that she finds him attractive. I played the weakling and battered my eyelashes at the captain of the guard. Child's play. The point being that I was able to move through human lands fairly easily. Whatever humans think a witch of the wild looks like, 'tis not I. Not that I did not have trouble. There are things about human society which have always puzzled me, such as the touching. Why all the touching for a simple greeting? Yes, yes, some men have painted lines across the maps. I've seen them. I'm sure the human world is very diverse, but the differences are mostly meaningless. There were many nuances that Flemeth could never tell me of. When to look into another's eyes. How to eat at a table. How to bargain without offending. None of these things I knew. I still do not understand it all, truth be told, but then I gave up long ago any hope of doing so. When I returned to the wilds last, I swore to Flemeth that I had no intention of leaving again. You are a fine one to be pointing out the humor of fate. Shall we examine your predicament on the whole? Let's not. Me? I prefer the jest on me to the jest on you. Well, let's get on with it before the ground opens up and swallows us, yes?
Something I can help with? What is meant by someone like me? Did you think I was always a cloistered sister? The Chantry provides succor and safe harbor to all who seek it. I chose to stay and become affirmed. The Chantry does not pride, and you should. I desired time apart from the world. I was a traveling minstrel in Orlais. Tales and songs were my life. I performed, and they rewarded me with applause and coin. And my skill in battle? Well, you pick up different skills when you travel, yes? Yes, of course. Let's move on.
What do you need? Ask away. Have you seen the uniform? It's not only stylish, but well made. I'm a sucker for good tailoring. I keep it hidden under my pillow. Sometimes I'll take it out just so I can hug it fondly and remember the good old days. Brings a tear to the eyes, you know. Oh, sure. They said that all the self-flagellation would be unpleasant, but you know what they say, one man's pain. You don't really want to know about my being a Templar, do you? It's really quite boring. Then let's just get back to what we were doing. No offense, but I'd really rather not discuss it. Yes.
Indeed.
Indeed.
Got to hand it to the Darkspawn. They sure know how to make a place feel desolate and foreboding. No more Darkspawn.
Said something.
I don't know whether to laugh or cry, but it's clearly Caelan's. There can be no doubt.
I shall do it. Come on. Very well. Shall be done.
What manner of beast is this? Be careful!
Judging, it's a pity we hadn't placed more trust in Orlais and less in the King's own father-in-law.
Blades like that inspire songs that last the ages.
Right ahead.
It has begun. powers, be...
Beware. So be it.
Forgive us, my king. Once we flushed the darkspawn from their holes and bought ourselves some time, we'll be back to see you.
Shall be done.
Trap right ahead.
I shall do it.
I shall do it.
Thank you.
shall be done.
Wait! We should search the bodies. I saw something back there that might have been Kalin's.
It has begun.
So be it. As you wish.
As you say.
Quiet as she goes, right?
It shall be done. It is begun. As you say.
Thank you.
Ugh, down the hole and into the deep. I don't even want to imagine where that leads.
Shall be done. I'll be done. Shall be done. Begun.
now!
I am ready.
You should run while you can. Let's end this.
There. That is the last of them. I only pray we can carry them as valiantly as he.
Very well.
Oh, they left him here to rot. We need to do something. He was a good man, who hoped too much, and died too young. He deserves what little honor we can afford to grant him.
I shall do it.
Are you sure I can't interest you in this hat? A pair of earrings, perhaps? I'm sure you'll be...
Enchantment?
Are you sure I can't in... I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods...
You have excellent taste. How nice. How nice. How nice. How nice.
A fine gift. You have my thanks.
Is that for me? Really? Wow! Wow!